Hey guys, so it's time for another therapy session review. So this one is gonna have the OT, which is the occupational therapist, and then a few days later, the main director over the whole therapy that Lucas is getting, she came as well, and then a couple days after that, the speech therapist also came. So they were all kind of in a couple of days range, so I thought I would wait and then I can just film it all at once. So let's just jump right in. So the occupational therapist came, and if you've seen any of my previous videos, she's just focusing on basically Lucas's tantrums and trying to figure out if it's really, like, you know, the terrible twos, or if he really has some kind of behavioral issues that we need to try to address and help him understand. She did two things that we wanted to focus on during her session. And the first thing she did was Lucas likes to, basically, if he doesn't get his way, if he doesn't get a snack that he wants, or if you're trying to play a toy with him, he kind of gets mad and then he'll throw himself to the ground. And sometimes he'll throw like a really big tantrum where he's just flat out screaming, crying, and whatnot. So if it's a bad tantrum and you know that, hey, Lucas isn't going to look at me and pay attention, she just said, let him calm down, give him a couple of minutes. But if he's kind of doing like a whiny cry, go over to him and give him a choice. So you could either say, Lucas, do you want a snack or do you want to play? So you kind of help him understand, hey, you have two choices and you need to pick your choice and you need to calm down and let's move on. And we've done that a few times. And he still gets a little upset, but I think he's understanding, okay, mom and dad say I have two choices, so I need to pick those and let's just move on. So he's been getting a little bit better about those tantrums. And the second thing we focused on was when Lucas plays with his toys and then he is done with something, he will literally take the toy and just kind of go, ugh, and then throw it, and then he's like, I'm done. And just kind of look at us. And before, in the past, I get on to him and I'm like, Lucas, you know, don't throw that. No, let's, you know, try to pick it up, whatnot. But the OT wanted to go a little farther with that because I was telling her what I do already, and she said that's good. But if he's not, you know, throwing a fit, like a crazy tantrum, take him over to the toy that he just threw. And again, tell him, no, we do not throw, and make him, of course, we have to kind of help him because he doesn't understand, but you take his hand and make him pick that toy up and bring it back over to the table or back over to where he had it and say, you know, no throw, and, you know, we can put this right here. And you just try to, you know, not like a long explanation, but you just kind of get like a good summary and tell him, hey, you know, we don't throw toys. You either leave it or put it away and move on. So overall, we worked with those two concepts for the OT. And he hasn't had too many of those going on, but we've been sticking with it and he's done really good. And I feel like he's starting to learn and understand about those certain techniques that we're working on. So a couple of days later, the overall director of the therapy came over, and like I said in the past, she comes every few weeks and she just kind of gets a good overview to see how he's doing. You know, okay, is therapy working? Is therapy not working? You know, should we go from here to here? Do we need to change our multitasking, you know, around? So anyway, she came over, did her little evaluation for an hour, just like the other people come over and do, and she was very, very pleased. She said, I see a big difference in Lucas. He still babbles a lot. So he's saying, I, and then he'll babble, like he's trying to say, you know, I, and then like a sentence, like he's trying to tell us about what he's doing. Or he'll come over and I'll go, hi, good morning, you know, in the first thing in the morning or whatnot, and he'll say, hi. Babble. So it's really cute because he's actually getting words down and he still babbles 98% more than he does with like just a word, but his babbling, I mean, it's just crazy how much he just kind of like would babble a word or two, but now he literally will babble like he's trying to tell you a sentence, like he's trying to tell you a story or something. I mean, he can babble for a good 30 seconds and it's so funny and cute, but I feel like that is a good positive because even though it's babble, it's not words, he's at least is trying, so that is great. So a couple of days later, the speech therapist came and we didn't really work on any new techniques. We kind of just grasped what she's already been doing and just kind of built on those. So we're still working on the body parts, and I told her, you know, sometimes he'll look at the body part, and she said, good, you know, when he looks at it, let's say he's looking at his toes, wiggling his toes, you say, you know, feet, feet, and he'll kind of get that understanding, oh, okay, so I'm looking at this, it's wiggling, this is my feet. So we've been working on that, and he seems more interested like in his elbows. He'll grab his elbows, so we'll tell him elbows, and he loves to grab his stomach, but I think he's got that down. So anyway, whenever he grabs a body part, we just make sure we say, you know, that's so-and-so, so-and-so, so he, you know, keeps hearing that word over and over, and hopefully he can eventually say it and more, you know, understanding later on. The speech therapist also was really happy that Lucas had improved in his babbling and words. She also saw a great improvement just like the director did, which was another positive for mommy here. I was so excited. I mean, he was a great babbler for both days, and still right now he's just babble, 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 so that's really good. But overall, the speech therapist, like I said, she didn't give us anything new, just kind of gave us, you know, keep working on this, keep working on that, and just kind of build on that. But she was really glad, more babbling. She was asking, was his lips moving whenever he was babbling? Because she was talking about, you know, if we don't notice his lips move, then we need to focus on something else and get that checked out. But I told her he says a lot of B's and P's, and I think it was M's that she wants to know. Because when you use those certain letters, you know, you move your mouth more than if you used another letter. So, and I told her, you know, he says ba 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 all the time. It sounds like he says bubbles sometimes, but I'm not sure if that's the word. But anyway, when she was finishing up and talking to me about that, he actually started saying B's and M's and P's, and she's like, okay, I hear it, so that's perfect. So anyway, all three sessions were really good. We're really going through with everything, so I feel like this is a great positive way that Lucas is going for his therapy, and I'm pretty excited. So thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next future videos. Bye guys.